Along with aiming and building, editing is one of the most vital mechanics in Fortnite. It enables you to create kill opportunities you otherwise wouldn't have and allows you to keep yourself away from harm, which is huge. Things like outplaying opponents in box fights, staying alive while you rotate in the end game, and retaking high ground without getting shot all require fast and effective editing. And the fact of the matter is this, being able to make quick edit plays is a large part of what separates the average Joes from the pros. Yes, that rhymed. What's going on, everybody? This is your guy. This is your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. And I just want to let you know, man, I'm your biggest fan, all right? I'm your number one fan, as a matter of fact. The sky is not the limit. You could do anything you put your mind to, and I want to help you be the best that you can be, not only in Fortnite, but also in life. Hey, I want you to connect with me right now on my Instagram as soon as you can. Hey guys, so today I'm going to be going over optimal settings and keybinds to speed up and improve your editing. Yes. Hey, we're going to start with a quick discussion about why editing is beneficial, then get into settings for keyboard and mouse, controllers, and even the new mobile settings that just dropped. Hope you guys are ready for this, man. It is about to go down. So before we get started, I just got one more thing to say. Hey, if you're looking to take your gameplay to the next level, I recommend you guys check out InstaPro, where we have live 24/7 coaching from some of the best players in the game. Head on over right now to ProGuides.com. Trust me, you're not going to regret this. All right, so with that being said, let's get into the good stuff. So while fighting, quick edits can be used to create openings that'll catch your opponents off guard. The quicker they are, the less time your enemies can react. Not just quick edits matter though, using the right type of edit will create an angle that benefits you more than your opponent. Edits such as the top right of a wall, the right corner of a floor, or a backward left side stare in somebody's box are all edits that are gonna give you the right side peeker's advantage. Those edits that take advantage of right side peeking and avoid those 50-50 style engagements are the ones you normally want to be doing. So on the defensive end, editing is used to keep yourself alive, as we should know that already, all right? Whether it's placing cones while ramp rushing or editing out to create a new turtle, being able to edit quickly is a must if you want to deny your opponent their kill opportunities. So when it comes to choosing the right edit keybinds, this is the questions I get asked all the time on my Insta, all right? You want to pick something that feels comfortable, all right? You don't want to be inconvenienced. You want something that's easier for you to do, right? And that's true no matter what device you play with. Usually, that ends up being what's easily accessible, isn't tiring to use, and it doesn't really hinder your in-game character movement too much. For keyboard and mouse, there are a few options you have to set up keybindings. First, there's the single edit keybind. This is the default way it's set up. Plenty of pros use this with no problems at all. Mashing a single key just isn't difficult or anything like that. You just need to make sure, as we said earlier, that the key is something that you can just easily hit that doesn't mess with your movement or the other functions too much. The keys closest to WASD or your spacebar, as well as side mouse buttons, are the most advantageous keybinds, okay? Keys like E, F, V, and C are all effective as they're close by and easy to hit. You would use your index fingers for all of these, except maybe for V, which you should definitely use your thumb for. Some players even like to use left shift, as your pinky finger usually rests, they're not doing anything else. But not everyone has the dexterity needed to constantly press down shift with their pinky, so most players avoid shift as their edit bind. So Mongo recently changed his edit bind from F to E. It seems like a silly change at first, since both F and E are just really, really close to where the index finger usually sits on D, but depending on how he rests his finger, E might actually be easier for him to hit. It just goes to show you that the changes the pros are willing to make to improve their gameplay, no matter how small they seem. Alright, so moving along to mice, we've got the side mouse buttons. The whole point of using side mouse buttons is that it can keep your fingers on WASD and not hamper your movement. But with how important movement is to have while building, most players just tend to save their two side mouse buttons for binding build pieces. Movement while editing is important too, but not nearly as much. The same concepts apply with controller keybinds. You want to be able to move freely while editing and not have your fingers jumping all over the place. The buttons you do choose depend on how you grip your controller, which we'll get into that later in the video. Aside from spending a lot of time grinding your edits in creative, which you should be doing 100% of the time if you're looking to improve, there are actually a few keybind setups that you can do to increase your editing speed. First and foremost, ladies and gentlemen, you should set up scroll wheel resets if you haven't done this already, okay? Scroll wheel resetting allows you to easily look at any one of your structures and spin your scroll wheel to reset the piece. To set this up, navigate to your input settings and set the secondary bind for building edit to mouse wheel up or mouse wheel down. Then you do the same for reset building edit. Compared to the default way of resetting edits, using your scroll wheel is much simpler and more effective. If you haven't set it up already, do yourself a favor and give it a shot. Now, there's also been a lot of talk in the past few months on double edit key binds. This is where you set the building edit bind to two separate keys pressed by different fingers. Most commonly, players set it to a keyboard key and a side mouse button. The idea is that it's slightly faster if you have separate keys for starting the edit and confirming it. You won't waste any time lifting your finger just to press the same key again, which can speed things up. Some players love double edit key binds. In theory, it can increase editing speed, right? But in all honesty, most keyboard and mouse pros don't even use it. It can take a long time just to get used to them, and in real matches, they can be somewhat even impractical. Not only that, but since we can only bind two keys to a function, it gets rid of the ability to reset with our scroll wheel. That is, unless you set up triple edit key binds. Yes. With this setup, you can keep the double binds, but also bring back scroll wheel resetting. To do this, you first set up your edit key binds to get scroll wheel resetting. Then you go into your keyboard software and remap the key that you want as your second edit button to your first one. So for instance, Tfue, who uses this setup, he puts his select edit to mouse 4 and scroll wheel up. Then, in his keyboard software, he remaps V to act as mouse 4. With this, he can perform scroll wheel resets while also having a second key to confirm his edits with. So what's the best option here? Well, I guess you can give double edits a try, or even triple binds if you're tech savvy, you know, enough to mess with your keyboard settings. Those can theoretically speed up your edits, but for most practical in-game uses, you don't need the crazy editing speeds that come with double or triple binds. Plus, it can take a lot of time to get used to double and triple editing binds. A lot of pro players agree, and most continue to stick with the single edit bind. Okay, so we said earlier that with the controller, you want to set up separate binds for each action of editing. One button for starting the edit, one for selecting the pieces, one for resetting, and one for confirming it. I get asked this question all the time on my Insta. Essentially, this is a double edit keybind setup with the controller. There really isn't a one-stop solution for the actual binds because it greatly depends on your preference and grip style that you want to use. So luckily though, controller keybind options in this game are amazingly expansive, so there are a lot of options available for you guys. For instance, if you play with the claw grip, you could use the left joystick to edit, right trigger to select the edits, right joystick to reset, and B circle to confirm. If you weren't on claw grip, pressing B circle would just take too long to reach. So replacing that with another free button like right bumper, that would be better. The main things that you want to avoid here are just unnatural and far finger movements. Your fingers should be resting on or near the buttons that you'll be pressing for the fastest inputs possible. Again, using two separate buttons is always faster than just using one. And unlike the keyboard and mouse, there's no scroll wheel reset setting you're losing out on by running the setup. The big downside is that it could take a long time to get used to these changes. You're not going to notice improvement immediately. It could take some time before you can just see it all. Our advice to you, okay, is just to not give up immediately, all right? Stick with the change, grind it out, and eventually your edits are going to become faster and more fluid. Edit mode sensitivity should always be turned up. The amount you increase depends on your preference as well, and as what you use for your normal X and Y values. If your normal sensitivity is on the low end, edit mode sensitivity can be put around 1.7 to 2.0 without feeling too fast. At higher X and Y values, only a slight bump is needed for edit mode sensitivity. But no matter what your normal look sensitivity is, you always want to set this to something above the default of 1. You don't need too much precision with editing, so speeds end up becoming a much more important factor. Edit mode aim assist is one of those options that only some players like. Traditionally, pretty much everybody turned this option off as it made editing too clunky and way too inconsistent. However, with the edit mode sensitivity turned up, this option works and feels a lot better than before. With faster crosshair movements on edits, they're less pulled from the aim assist. So it's not as restrictive and actually can help prevent overshooting certain edits. If you're still playing with it off, we recommend turning it on and giving it another shot. Again, it's completely your preference, so hey, you never know, you might end up liking it. Some amazing new sensitivity options just dropped for mobile in the latest patch. Hey, mobile players. First, players can now have a building and editing sensitivity they can adjust. The problem seems to be that they max out at the default value of 1, meaning you can only make them slower. Building and editing on a lower sensitivity doesn't really give you an advantage, okay? It just makes things slower. But luckily, Epic is quick on the fix this time, thank God. By the next patch, they'll allow us to set the multiplier higher than 1. Just like with controllers, setting this above 1 will significantly increase the speed of editing on mobile, which is great news for you guys. Another new setting is the edit confirm on release, which allows the edit to confirm whenever edit selection is released. This should save loads of time, especially with many consecutive edits. Other than some very minor downsides, this setting is going to be instrumental in speeding things up. It'll be a must-have going forward. Another new addition to help mobile players is the new Edit Select Reset button, available to equip in the HUD Layout tool. You can reset edits easily with two tabs on a single button. It might take some time to get used to, but it's a massively beneficial upgrade in terms of functionality. Every mobile player should start using this button. Lastly, there's a touch acceleration option now, which when set to the lowest value, it gets rid of the look acceleration tied to how fast you slide your fingers across the screen. Basically, with acceleration off, sliding your finger 1 inch on your screen will always produce the same crosshair movements in game, no matter what speed you flick at. Pretty much every PC player has mouse acceleration turned off, as it makes crosshair movements just much more consistent. However, that's with the mouse, which is a very maneuverable device. I'm sure we all agree on that. Depending on your sensitivity, acceleration may be a lot more important to have on mobile than on PC. So we recommend leaving the setting for last and only messing with it if you're having trouble making consistent edits. To summarize, if you rely on scroll wheel resetting as a keyboard and mouse player, you have single edit and triple edit keybind options. Theoretically, triple edit binds provide for the fastest editing possible, but most players can't push it to the extreme where it ends up having a significant value. So in the end, most pros stick with the single keybind option, choosing a bind next to their movement keys such as F, E, or C. Controller players have a lot more options when it comes to their binds. Not having to worry about scroller resetting means that they can use double edit binds with a lot less restriction. The actual binds used can depend on the grip style, but mainly you want individual buttons pressed by different fingers for each edit action. The new mobile options are a huge leap for mobile editing. While the sensitivity slider is sort of useless right now, it'll be fixed soon by Epic and should allow for faster editing when turned up. Edit confirm on release, as well as the new edit select reset button, should both be turned on as they remove some unnecessary steps, speeding things up. As always, with any settings changes, you won't notice immediate results. It could take a long time getting used to the new keybinds, especially if you're going from a single edit bind to two of them. Spend time in creative. I repeat, spend time in creative and keep practicing. Sooner or later, you're gonna see the results come. Once again, this is your guy, your friend Keith Allen. Hey, connect with me right now on my Instagram if you haven't had the chance. Follow me, we got a lot going on. Leave us a comment letting us know what changed after you watched this video, and make sure to like it if we helped you out in any way, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, guys.